The first station. Jesus is condemned to death. We adore thee, O Christ, and we bless thee, because by thy saving cross thou hast redeemed the world. Pontius Pilate is often the focus of reflections on the first station. A man with the power of life and death over others. A man who condemns an innocent man to death. Definitely not a person like me. Yet in the current COVID crisis, I could easily become just like him. If I am cocooning, do I remain within my home and garden? Do I go out only to shop for essential food and household goods or to attend medical appointments? When I do shop, do I bulk shop to minimize the trips I make? If I do go out, do I remain within 2 kilometers of my home? Do I wash my hands properly and regularly? Do I maintain social distancing? If not, I too could be condemning an innocent person to death. Generous and merciful God, fill us with compassion and concern for others, young and old, that we may look after each other in these challenging times, especially those among us who are vulnerable.
The second station of the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and bless you, because by thy holy cross you have redeemed the world. Jesus takes up his cross. Like us, he has carried many crosses in his own life, which he carried courageously with trust in the will of God the Father. He carried the cross of poverty, the threats of the Pharisees, and the lack of understanding of his disciples. We ourselves and many others in our world may carry the cross of physical or mental suffering, isolation, discrimination, and failure. Jesus invites us to hand over our sufferings to him. We can ask him to help us to have the courage to share those burdens with others who can be of assistance to us. May we also reach out to those who need us. May we help others to carry their cross and never to make life difficult for our neighbour through either prejudice or indifference.
The third station, Jesus falls for the first time. We adore thee, O Christ, and we bless thee. Because of your cross, you have redeemed the world. Jesus fell down there. Is it any wonder? With the weight of that huge cross? It's massive. I could see him weakening all right. And eventually, down he went. The poor man. And would anyone go to help him? Not one. They're scared of the soldiers, I suppose. And talking of soldiers, all they want to do is get this over with and go home. They keep yelling at Jesus. Get up! Get up! Come on! Get up! Well, Jesus, thank you for all you did for us. Along with carrying that cross and giving your life, you carry us every single day. And you carry the burden of our sins. Imagine that. Thank you, Jesus.
Fourth station, Jesus meets his mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you, because by your cross you have redeemed the world. What must you have felt walking up that hill? A crowd of shouting, jeering people lining each side, mocking and hurling insults at you. You look around for a friendly face, someone who will give you moral support on this nightmare journey. And then your eyes meet. Your mother is there for you, and looking into those loving but pain-filled eyes, you know she is suffering just as much as you are. Just by being present, she helps you along the remainder of your journey. That is what a mother does. Understand, care, wipe away tears, bring in a ray of sunshine. Haven't we all felt it with our own mothers, rocks of support throughout our lives? I sometimes feel overwhelmed by many things in life. I need to remember that I don't have to solve every problem all by myself. All I do is look around me for a friendly face for the help I need. Jesus and Mother Mary, I know I have caused you pain and suffering at times on my journey through life. But I also know that as the two of you were together so closely on that horrific journey to Calvary, you will also be with me, supporting and loving me when I need it most.
The fifth station, Simon of Cyrene helps Jesus to carry his cross. We adore thee, O Christ, and we bless thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. As the soldiers led him away, they seized Simon from Cyrene, who was on his way in from the country, and put the cross on him and made him carry it behind Jesus. An expert in the law asked Jesus, "Who is my neighbor?" In these testing times, we are finding out the answer to this question. In a meditative poem called Lockdown, Capuchin brother Richard Hendrick reflects on this. They say that in the streets of Assisi, people are singing to each other across the empty squares, keeping their windows open so that those who are alone may hear the sounds of family around them. Open the windows of your soul, and though you may not be able to touch across the empty square, sing. Good Master, you allowed Simon, a stranger, to become your helper in your ordeal on the way to Calvary. Help me to reach out like him to the needy, irrespective of their color, class, or creed. May I be your servant too, extending a helping hand to anyone who is struggling with a heavy burden.
The sixth station of the cross. Veronica wipes the face of Jesus. We adore you, O Christ, and bless you, because by thy holy cross you have redeemed the world. Veronica sees Jesus in great distress and suffering. She courageously moves out from the crowd to wipe away the blood and sweat from his face with a cloth. The image of the disfigured face of Jesus is left on the cloth. We see the disfigured face of Jesus when we see the tears of the hungry, the victims of physical and sexual abuse, the depressed and the lonely. Do we reach out and try to bring comfort, support, and healing? Lord, give us the generosity of heart to give love and support to those who suffer.
The seventh station, Jesus falls the second time. We adore thee, O Christ, and we bless thee. Because of your cross, you have redeemed the world. Here we go again. He's down again. Sure, it's no surprise between the size of the cross and the weight of it. And having to drag it up that hill. What a man. And he keeps on trying. Hold on. He's struggling to his feet. He's up and he's walking again. Well, not exactly walking, stumbling more like. Wouldn't we be doing well if we had but a fraction of his determination? You know the way. The way we throw in the towel. How we break our promises. The way we fall back on old habits. All we have to do is look to Jesus as our model. No more so than during the present crisis. Thank you, Jesus, for the inspiration.
Eighth station. Jesus meets the women of Jerusalem. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you, because by your cross you have redeemed the world. Jesus, during your life on earth, not once ever did you stop loving us, even during the time of your greatest agony, scourged and made a mockery of, and abandoned by your friends. You are suffering greatly as you carry your cross up that hill. You see a group of women along the side of the road, and you notice they are quite distressed about you. Then you do the incredible. You stop to spend a moment with them. Daughters of Jerusalem, weep not for me, but weep for yourselves and your children. Jesus, your meeting with the women is a lesson for me. Help me to think more about others, that others have problems too, the poor, the lonely, those who are depressed. Help me respect them and respond to them, even when I'm busy or preoccupied with my own problems. But Jesus, you are also telling us we need to look after ourselves as well, because it is only when we are strong and full of your Spirit that we can help others.
The ninth station. Jesus falls the third time. We adore thee, O Christ, and we bless thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. Jesus falls three times on his way to Calvary. Traditionally, in representations of the stations, Jesus falls lower with each fall until, in the ninth station, he is completely flattened on the ground under the weight of the cross. Let us pause for a moment and think of those for whom these trying times feel like the last straw, who feel completely flattened by the cross they bear. Keep us, good Lord, under the shadow of your mercy in this time of uncertainty and distress. Sustain and support the anxious and fearful, and lift up all who are brought low, that we may rejoice in your comfort, knowing that nothing can separate us from your love. In Christ our Lord. Amen.
The tenth station of the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and bless you, because by thy holy cross you have redeemed the world. Jesus is stripped of his garments. His executioners violently strip Jesus of his clothes and then cast dice to determine the ownership of them. He surrenders everything as a ransom for all. We too can strip people of their dignity when we take away their good name through gossip, or when the media unnecessarily exposes all the intimate details of their lives. Men, women, and children are also stripped of their dignity when they are portrayed as objects in the pornographic industry. May we always respect the unique dignity of every human being and leave judgment to God. Let us look for the good in those we meet and so enable them to reach their full potential.
The 11th station. Jesus is nailed to the cross. We adore thee, O Christ, and we bless thee. Because of your cross, you have redeemed the world. What are they doing? Oh no, they're taking out nails and hammers. This is outrageous. They've lost it altogether. They're going to nail him to the cross? I wouldn't mind, but Jesus never did anything but good all his life. and this is the thanks he gets. Tragic. I just don't know what to say, Jesus. I suppose you were a bit outside the ordinary, all right. You know what? That makes me wonder. Have we learned any lesson from the way you were abused? Is the same kind of stuff happening today? Maybe it's time we all had a good look at our own behaviour towards other people.
Twelfth Station. Jesus dies on the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you, because by your cross you have redeemed the world. He had hung there on the cross for 3 hours, his lifeblood ebbing away until none was left. And then he cries out in a loud voice, "It is accomplished!" The job was done. He achieved what he had come on earth to do. Show everyone that God's love is boundless and has no reservation. He forgave not only the soldiers who had crucified him, but also the countless people down through the ages who have failed to love others. This was like the gates of a massive dam in heaven, opening wide and letting out huge torrents of love spill out over all the people. They could now live in true love with God, knowing that their sins were forgiven, and in true love with their neighbours, knowing that Jesus had given everything of himself for each one of us. Jesus, let your outpouring of love on the cross remind us that very same love is with us each day in the people around us and in the spectacular creation of nature.
The 13th Station of the Cross. Jesus is taken down from the cross. The body of Jesus is finally removed from the cross, and he is placed in the loving arms of his heartbroken mother. This is the body of Christ, which has been broken to redeem us from our sins. As Mary cradles the lifeless body of her son and offers him back to the Father, all parents who have lost a child through illness, violence, suicide, addiction, and abduction can identify with what Mary must have felt at that time. Her son, who is all kindness and goodness, is brutally and unjustly executed, and the loss is unimaginable. Help us, Lord, in the partings of loved ones that will happen in our lives. Be with us and comfort us. Let us not despair, but find hope in the resurrection of Christ and his promise to us of everlasting life and a home with him in heaven.
14th Station. Jesus is laid in the tomb. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you, because by your cross you have redeemed the world. Jesus, disgraced and mistreated, is honourably buried in a new tomb. This looks as if everything is over, as if all of his work for the previous 3 years has been in vain. But now, Jesus' own word strikes us forcibly. Unless a grain of wheat falls to the earth and dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Think of autumn. The ground is littered with fruit, seeds and nuts, which look very much dead. The following spring, nature bursts forth in all of its splendour. Jesus is like that grain of wheat which dies. From that lifeless grain of wheat comes forth the great multiplication of bread which will endure until the end of the world. Jesus is that bread of life which can satisfy the hunger of all humanity, our hunger for love and fulfillment and well-being. Jesus offering himself to us each day provides us with our deepest nourishment. Let us see you, Jesus, in the beauty of nature, and especially in the beauty of people around us so that we can partake of your nourishment.